Hello and welcome to this aga-cad tips and tricks video. I will demonstrate some advanced ways to place tags in Revit according to element position and rotation in a given view. For the first example, I'm in the heating plan. Here I have radiators placed along the outside walls, and tags for these radiators usually need to be moved to the outside of the building. For tagging many similar elements in a view, you might be using Revit's tag all function. But with tag all, most of the tags will appear on the inside of the building because I cannot control the position of these tags. Tag all also tagged the heated towel racks because they are the same category, even though I wanted to use a different tag family for them. But there's a workaround for all this. First, I will delete all the tags in this view, and I will drag the tag toolbar into the drawing area for quick access. Now I will select only the radiators that are facing south and use tag all for selected elements only. Notice that I'm not using a leader line. Next, I will pick one tag and use select all instances visible in view, move all of the tags down, and temporarily hide them in a view. Now these tags will no longer get selected. To make this more effective, I will use keyboard shortcuts. Select radiators on the other facade, tag all, select one, keyboard shortcuts for select similar, then move, and temporary hide. And repeat for the other facades. Select everything and then tag. Select one tag, shortcuts for select similar, move, and temporary hide. And one more time, select and tag. Select similar and move out. After that, I can unhide everything and all of my radiator tags are where I want them. If needed, I can add leader lines as well. Select all instances visible in view and tick this checkbox. To double check if everything is tagged, I will select a tag and a radiator and isolate category. Here I can clearly see that I haven't missed a single radiator. Even though this tagging approach is faster and less mistake prone than tagging one by one, it's still not ideal and the towel racks still aren't tagged. So now I will delete all the tags and then I will grab aga-cad's smart documentation tool. It has element tagging by rules functionality, so it will make this job fast and easy. I have a configuration already prepared, so I'm going to click OK to run it. And just like that, my tags are placed exactly how I need them to be, on the outside of the building. Also, I would like to point out that using just one configuration, I've placed two different tags, one for radiators and a different one for heated towel racks. That's because I can predefine tag placement rules in the tag configuration. For example, for the first tag, I have filtered only the radiators and I'm using this tag. For the second tag, I have filtered the heated towel racks and I'm using a different tag. And the element face offset setting is what moved the radiator tags outside the building. Smart documentation's tagging functionality can be used with elements of almost any Revit category. To demonstrate that, let's jump to a second example. Here I'm in the architectural model and let's say that I need to tag all the doors in this view. Let's use tag all first. With tag all, some of the tags are overlapping and they also obstruct the walls. To batch tag all the doors the way I need, I will delete the tags first and then I will use another tagging configuration that I've created using smart documentation. Instantly, all the tags are placed and they are all on the door swing side because of the element face offset. That's it for this video. I hope you found out something new and useful, and stay tuned for more tips and tricks. Thank you for watching and see you next time.
AGA CAD, building BIM together.